Very good morning, children. In this video, some of the terms that are related to the sexual reproduction in flowering plants we are going to see. These are some of the terms which are related to this chapter, that is chapter 7, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In that we are going to see some of the strategies that a bisexual chasmogamous flower can evolve to present self-pollination. Some of the three terms we are going to see. So in that, the first one we are going to see is dichogamy. Sex organs mature at a different tissues, that is protandry. Andrecium matures earlier than gynoecium in different times. So it is of two types. Dichogamy is the sex organs mature at different times, and that is involved in two types, that is protandry and protogyny. So protandry means in which the andrecium, which is also the male sex organs, which matures earlier than gynoecium, and protogyny in which the female sex organs, also the gynoecium, matures earlier than andrecium. So example for protandry is sunflower, and the example for protogyny is Dadura or Solanum. And the second term in this, or the second strategy in the bisexual chasmogamous flower, is hercogamy. Hercogamy is nothing but the sex organs are placed at different positions or in different directions. Example, hibiscus or gloriosa. And next strategy is heterostyly, in which the styles of the flowers of same species are in different heights. So example is salvia. And the next strategy is self-sterility. Self-sterility is also called as self-incompatibility, in which the stigma prevents the germination of self pollen. Okay, example is abutilon. And the next strategy in the bisexual chasmogamous is dichogamy, which is also the unisexuality. The unisexual, that is the male or female flowers are produced. Example, castor, maize, papaya, etc. And in the next few terms we are going to learn in the sexual reproduction of the flowering plants is the types. There are number of types of pollen tube entry into the ovary with the help of the some of the parts. It is also called the process of fertilization in the angiosperms. There are three ways, that is porogamy, and the second one is chalazogamy, and the third one is mesogamy. So now coming to the porogamy, in which the pollen tube enters the ovule through micropyle, that is called as porogamy. The example is hibiscus. And the second one is mesogamy, in which the pollen tube enters the ovule through integuments, and the example is cucurbita. So in which the ovules will enter through the integuments, also called as, or else a funiculus. So in mesogamy, the pollen tube enters the ovule through integument or funiculus, and the example is cucurbita. And the third one, that is chalazogamy, in which the pollen tube enters the ovule through chalaza. Okay, and the example is casuarina. So these are the three terms. The three ways in which the entry of pollen tube into the ovule occurs in the sexual reproduction of the. And now we are going to see the other process of fertilization, that is the triple fusion, and where and how does it takes place, and what is the nuclei that is involved in the triple fusion we are going to see. This is one more process which involves the fertilization in the flowering plants. So when coming to the triple fusion, the fusion of second male gamete with the secondary nucleus. Okay, the fusion of second male gamete with the secondary nucleus is formed by the fusion of two polar nuclei is called the triple fusion. And where does this triple fusion occurs? It occurs in the embryo sac. In triple fusion, the second male gamete discharged by the Bollen tube unites with the secondary nucleus. And which nuclei that is involved in the triple fusion is one male gamete and secondary nucleus. The secondary nucleus is nothing but the two polar nuclei unite to form this secondary nucleus, and these are involved, that is one male gamete and the secondary nucleus, which are involved in the parthenocarpy and apomixis. Okay, this in the triple fusion. And the other terms that is involved in the sexual reproduction of the flowering plants is apomixis and parthenocarpy. So these are the two processes which are involved. In that we are going to discuss about the apomixis and what is its benefits. Apomixis, it is nothing but the production of seeds without fertilization. And what are its uses? So the benefits we can discuss here is characters are stable for several generations, and simplicity is the production of hybrids. So it is a simpler form. Apomixis is a simpler form for the production of hybrids, and they are useful to produce uniform rootstock and a virus-free materials we can see in apomixis. The next term is parthenocarpy. This parthenocarpy is nothing but the production of fruits without fertilization. Apomixis is the production of seeds without fertilization, and parthenocarpy is the production of fruits without fertilization. And what is its use? The parthenocarpy process benefits commercial production of seedless fruits, where we can see like grapes, we can see. And it's also more useful in juice, jam and jelly industries. We can see the best example is grapes. We can see seedless grapes, so which is useful for making of juice without seeds we can make, and also some of the jam and jelly industries also we can see. And yes, there is a difference between this apomixis and parthenocarpy. That is what apomixis is the production of seeds without fertilization, and parthenocarpy is nothing but the production of fruits without fertilization. So these are the some terms or something you have to learn in the sexual reproduction of flowering plants. Thank you.